Yeah, understand.
Hey, how you doing?
What up?
Hey, what's going on?
Not much. Just reviewing music,
Frozen.
Staying quarantined, kind of living life. What, we're frozen?
Awesome. No. My second name is pronounced Sussett, by the way.
Sussett. Perfect.
Sussett.
Is that like
Sussett?
I see. French. Oui, oui.
Is Sussett, you said?
Sussett.
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 There you go.
So how's quarantine been treating you? You've been staying
Man,
inside?
It's been such a ride. It's been like a roller coaster of emotions this quarantine.
Mm-hmm. Can only imagine.
Especially because of, you know, me trying to make music for the past 2 years since American Idol, the show, and just like trying to find my lane, which I am there kind of.
Yes.
But yeah, this quarantine is being very productive. I'll say that. I've been reading a lot. Just like, you know, working on my personal growth, trying to be as creative as I can be. But it's been quite difficult.
Yeah,
I think
I didn't mean to interrupt.
Yeah.
But you're in Miami, right? Is it kind of crazy down there? Like,
no, it's actually, well, it was crazy at the beginning because of spring break. Like, there was a lot of people in the streets, and then the cops started getting a little crazy trying to control people. But now it's like, you know, they close the beaches, the parks, but still people's in the street, you know, people go to the parks, and it's not like, New York is completely shut down.
Oh, nice. So I guess for everybody who doesn't know in the chat, if you want to tell everybody a little bit about you, what you've done, where you're from, anything. Can tell
yeah, us. Absolutely. Well, my name is Michelle Sussett, guys. I'm 24. I'm a little weird sometimes, so if it gets weird,
that's great.
I've been in the United States for 6 years. I got here when I was 19, and then I always had this dream of going to American Idol because from Venezuela, you don't really get a lot of options. So I always was a fan of the show, and I was like, if I ever go to the United States, if I ever move, because I have family here when I was living in Venezuela. So I had that hope of like one day I can go live with my family. And I always thought going to American Idol was going to be the way for me to become a professional singer and live out of music. And, you know, I started praying a lot, literally like by praying and by believing I could make it. I got here and like 3 years later, I went into the show. I didn't know much English, but I still, you know, I went for it. And I did top 10. I was the only Latina in the very first season on ABC. Because I used to be in Fox and then ABC.
How long have you been in the States?
6 years.
Nice.
By June, this June, I'm going to be 6 years.
So did you have, you gave me a lot of questions to think about. Did you always have going to American Idol as a dream, like while in Venezuela?
Yeah. So I kind of got obsessed with the show when Jessica Sanchez was on the show.
Okay.
Just because she was such a young girl and like her voice was so amazing. I was like, oh my God, that's the level I want to be competing with, you know, not competing, but like just being
sharing the stage with people that sing so great.
Yeah. Absolutely.
And another thing I thought about, is Venezuela probably worse or not as bad as I feel like it is?
Well, right now, unfortunately, they're not keeping count exactly of how the coronavirus is affecting, because honestly, the system and the government in Venezuela is so messed up, they don't keep track of anything. As far as economically, yeah, it's doing pretty bad. Like a lot of people lost their jobs. A lot of people are basically, you know, trying to find food and trying to sell food and make money to, you know, to just survive. That's my mom's situation right now. Thank God I'm able to support her financially right now. But yeah, it's really hard. And they even closed like the small cities. They have the military not allowing people to go out and come in, which is crazy to me because I feel like my mom lives in an area that's like a small town. And there's not really a lot of things to do.
So
I think they should allow people. What was that?
They're like locking it down, like individual areas.
So whenever they have to go out, I mean they close it at certain times, but even during the day, like there's some areas that you are not allowed or that are blocked, and then you have to drive around. Like it's based on what my family told me, it's crazy.
Wow. Heavy.
Yeah, man. But you know, I keep my prayers up. I keep my prayers up, and I always pray for my mom and my family, and
Yeah, and then
that
you've
everything
came
will
here
work
and
out
you've
for
done
the
a
best.
lot. And so, I mean, getting on American Idol is not easy. We've talked to a lot of people from the show, and you know, it's extremely impressive just getting past the first round. You know, never mind you making top 10. Like, that's such a long journey, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, it is. It took me a long time to recognize that, but it is.
Yeah, and that's something people we I say it all the time. And so I might as well, like, they don't realize how hard it is, I think. When they watch the show, they probably, people don't think about it. You know, how difficult it could be, you know, like learning a whole song and performing it, you know, within a week or things of that nature, you know, it's challenging.
Yeah, people don't have it. People have zero idea. I literally think people's just there like, yeah, entertain me.
Yeah,
Let
like
me
it's
judge you. Let me see what's up.
like they go to
Like
the bar and
you don't
watch
know the struggle,
karaoke.
the mentally, physically, like all the years you gotta prepare to be in the show and to like feel confident about yourself, you know?
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah.
So, you've been working on new music, right?
For about 2 years.
2 years. Did you figure out what genre you're kind of trying to like focus in on?
Well, right now my first song is a reggae chill song.
Okay.
And now the rest of the songs I want to focus on like an acoustic sound, more like guitar and real instruments. I don't want to fall too much into the electronic and beats and all of that. I
Yeah.
want to use real instruments.
More raw, natural
And
sound.
if I think about a genre, I would think like urban pop rock.
Okay. That's
Yeah.
cool.
So, are you gonna perform something for us? Like you got music? What's going on? Like you wanted the people
Yeah, for
want to hear
sure.
you.
I have a couple covers, and I also have an original song. I just learned it on the guitar because I honestly didn't know it, but I just learned it.
Oh, so you
Which
play
one you want me
guitar?
to?
All right.
I'm learning. I'm getting there. And piano a little bit. I realized that a way of me translating what I want to do with the producers
Right.
was kind of like an issue after
Yeah.
American Idol because I didn't play anything, was
Yeah,
like
just to
too
learn
hard.
it.
So now that now I
Yeah.
can literally like, okay, this is what do you think? You know, this is what I like, this is what I want to follow.
Yeah. No, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. Yeah, whatever you wanna sing, you can
Because people
definitely
love it. I don't know if you see
just
the chat,
pick.
but everybody's saying you're amazing and much love. And
No. How do I see the chat? I can't see
you're on your phone right now, right?
it.
Yeah, forget about it.
The only way
Right,
would
I'll
be to
watch
maybe
an
go on the
interview
computer.
later. I mean, unless you have a laptop or a tablet going around, but I don't know, man. It might take like years, you feel me? Who knows? The internet is just not what it is right now.
Everyone's using it. They
It's
weren't
not what it
ready.
is right now. I don't know.
Yeah, it is what it is. Well, for whoever's watching, like, thank you for the love. I appreciate it. All right.
Word.
So I'm gonna play the reggae song. I
Yeah.
literally just learned it like 15 minutes ago, so.
Sweet. I love reggae.
Seduciendo, yo solo sé que me quedó grabada la canción que escuchas y el olor de tu almohada. Entre esos gustos casi parecidos, tu energía con la mía había coincidido. Pero ese fin de semana tú no me contestabas. Háblame claro, no llames más. Te hablo claro, sé que valgo más. Tú sabes que ahora me llama porque tiene rato teniéndome ganas. Si no me tratas como reina, no me llames, no me hables. mañana. Háblame claro cuando llames más. Te hablo claro, sé que va algo más. Ya sabes que ahora mismo porque tengo el rato teniéndome ganas. Si no me toques como reina, no me llames, no me da la gana. Gana, gana, gana. Gana, gana. No me llames más.
I wish you would have had Google Translate on the screen for me so I can understand what you were saying.
No, when you started going fast, I was like, yeah, that's awesome.
Google Translate is my friend. Listen, man, I like that right there, man.
I need to know Spanish.
So again, tell me why there isn't any music that I can't find right now so I can plug you in.
That's a great question. So,
I mean, we got right, all the time.
About to come out. We're planning on coming out soon. You know, with this whole coronavirus, like we had already right. a date, but now it's like, well, we might as well just do it. So the reason why I don't have any music out is because my manager and I, we wanted to kind of wait for the right moment, you know,
right.
like prepare the music, prepare a whole concert. Cause he wanted to start with singles, but I told him that I wanted to make an album because I feel like it's more of an artistic way of coming out as an artist. You come up with a statement, like something right. that you want to say. Yeah, singles is valid too. That's what, you know, that's what Dua Lipa did and it's cool. But I also, you know, that's what I wanted. So I wanted to develop and it took us a couple of years. Then we also had the opportunity to speak with the label. And so nice. That delayed things even more.
Yeah.
And
it's coming.
So are you signed right now or are you just shopping?
I can't really say much about that. Secret. I'll probably talk about it soon, but I'm waiting for the right moment.
So I hear you say right moment a lot. So what is the right moment for you to actually release music? I mean, I know you said you were developing your sound, but what is the right moment for you?
Well, I feel to me the right moment is just like feel 100% secure about what are you coming out with and what your music want to express and what's the message. Because right. a lot of the times when you're in the studio, you can make a song, you know, you make tons of songs, but not all of those songs represents you as an artist.
Right.
That's one thing that happened to us a lot. We were like, yeah, this song is cool, but it's not for me.
Yeah.
And so basically, yeah, for me, the right moment is like knowing for sure that this is me.
And and since you decided to build the whole album, I mean, that kind of puts you behind schedule. You got to wait until you finish it all and you've probably made a bunch of songs. You don't want to put them out. So how many songs do you think you made? Like that?
The way I understand what you're saying, but maybe let me see if I understood. So the way we want to do it is start putting singles out and then having already the idea of the album. So we don't delay any release.
Nice. Yeah. So you have the album done and then you'll start dropping singles. Yeah. A lot of artists do it usually like that.
Yeah.
They start dropping the singles. So you'll drop maybe two or three max, and then the whole album will come out.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
No, that's smart.
So how long has this project been in development?
For about 2 years, but honestly, to be honest, like, it's been a roller coaster of emotions, because after the show of American Idol, my mental health wasn't at its best, and so I had to take care of myself, and that took me a little while.
You're not the only one.
Also, what was that?
You're not the only one. It's hard.
Yeah,
everybody.
Yeah, man, it's a reality. You know, we artists, everybody, we gotta take care of our mental health, otherwise things won't flow. Things will flow the way we want to, and in a harmonious way. I was taking care of myself and also working on music little by little. That's why it's been taking so long. To me especially, like, it's just hard to have my mom so far away. Like, I don't want to blame it on the fact that I have my mom far away, but it's like I haven't seen my mom in 6 years, and it's like,
wow.
And also gotta work to send her money. So all of those things.
Yeah, it's a struggle.
But it's a struggle. It's part of the... I love it. I love it. Because at the end of the day, it just makes you stronger, you know?
Right.
Whatever you might be going through.
Yep.
Right. When's the next time you're going back to Venezuela?
I'll become a citizen next year. So when I become a citizen is when I'm able to go back.
Nice.
Yes. Congrats.
Nice. You're going to go back with all the gifts? All the...
Oh.
You gotta go back with the album. That's what you gotta do. You gotta go back with the album and be like, listen, this is what I did over there.
Hand them out like candy.
I don't know about all that candy. I don't know, but you know,
I would.
You might, I don't know, man. Like, I used to sell mixtapes, bro. I don't know, man. I don't know.
If you used to sell mixtapes?
Yo,
where?
Yo, everywhere. Hollywood, Vegas. Yeah, I sold
you in the Hollywood too. In the Hollywood
Sunset Boulevard, where else? Vegas on that strip.
I went with the guy in Miami.
Say, yo.
The guy Nino Blue. I don't know if anybody, he was the Kanye kid.
Yeah, I remember Nino Blue.
And me and him before, I think it was before he met Kanye. Me and him were in Miami. I went to Rolling Loud, but he happened to be there Uber driving. And one night he's like, hey, I want to go to wherever the beach strip is in Miami. And he's like, there's this place and Post Malone's going to be there. And I want to meet people and give them a mixtape. So me and him go at like 3 a.m. and we're standing outside this club looking like bums. And he's got a backpack on and he's got a full of CDs and he's like trying to hand them out to people. Oh, it was hilarious.
What year was that?
I think it was 2000.
Farther back than that.
Okay.
Maybe 18.
Took your CDs? Did anyone took your mixtapes?
Yeah, a lot.
Good.
You couldn't turn me down. Listen, I was over here like, yo, you're gonna take this mix. I think it was only like four girls in particular that did not take my mixtape, and I was so salty. I was like, bruh, what? Like, I'm giving you this for free, and you're gonna look at me like I'm crazy. Like, what? Get out of here. Get out of here, man. Listen, it's a struggle when you're an artist, especially when you're independent, trying to get known. You pretty much gotta, you know, get it how you live. That's the fun part though. Just the come up and the actual hand to hand and the interaction, like all of that is like the fun part. Like, I don't think people understand when you get so big that you can't do anything, it becomes like
well, it's the story of your life, it gives you character.
Yeah, I guess. We good.
Well, I personally, I started singing on the streets when I first got here.
Come on. I'm a street performer, man. What's up? I like that, man.
I bought my speakers.
I had like a little tip jar
and the cheap
mic.
Dang.
Yeah, man. And I was like, it was horrible. Like, I didn't know the lyrics of most of the songs. Because, you know, I was still learning English, and you would see me like singing with like a paper in my hand.
That is dope, though.
People would pass me by. You know, the biggest money I made was like $70 in one day. I was like,
nice.
Wow. Amazing.
Nice.
But yeah, people pass me by and be like, mm-hmm. No, but that actually, you know, it's crazy. Like when you put yourself in, when you get out of your comfort zone, you achieve things. So one thing that happened to me while singing on the streets is like this random guy who was selling balloons and was doing like circus things.
This is about
he
to be
looked
funny.
Kind of crazy, not to
go ahead, go ahead.
He looked kind of crazy to me, but he told me out of the blue, he was like, "Hey, there's this competition for $5,000 in this casino. You should go on Sunday and sing, and maybe you can win the $5,000." So I went the first Sunday. I was in second place. I think they gave me like $50. Then
Nice.
I went the third Sunday, and I won the first place, and they gave me $250. And they were like, "Okay, now you enter the competition for the $5,000."
Oh wow!
How'd that go?
Man, so let me tell you the whole story. My uncle worked for UPS, and one day he was delivering a package, and he met this vocal coach. So he came back home, and it was like, "Hey, I met this vocal coach. You should go see her." And I was like, "Yeah, for sure, because I have a competition for $5,000. You know, I'm gonna make it. So I went. I started taking classes. And I won the competition, man.
Wow.
Yeah, man.
I won the $5,000. I was so proud
That's
of me.
Amazing.
And I had so much support because this vocal coach became kind of like my second mom.
What did you do with that $5,000? Did you blew it? What happened? What did you do with it?
Nah, man, I bought myself a Mitsubishi Lancer 2005. It was a horrible car. It was a horrible car for a lady, but I bought it and I was like, "Okay, I need a car." And then I sent $1,000 to my mom.
Nice.
And then the rest of the money, I think
you blew it.
I don't know what I did with it.
You blew it. That's what that is right there. Come on, man.
That's awesome. That's amazing. Man.
Yeah, man.
Competitions
is definitely something that's really fun for artists to come up. As long as you treat it as such, you know, like there's people that take it too serious, and I know it's a serious thing. You know, you want to get out there as an artist, but it the more important thing is to have fun. You know what I mean? Like you sound like you had fun doing that whole journey. That's what's up, man.
You know that what you're saying is so key, and like. I feel like it's something that you got to keep on reminding yourself every day
because
you forget. I literally like a month and a half ago when I was trying to create and things wouldn't flow, I was like, I'm having fun and I got to have fun. And it's something that you got to remind yourself every day. Thank you. That's key.
Man, look at the chat being all antsy. They want to know if you can sing another song for them.
Yeah, they're pushing.
Yeah, for sure. Let me see here.
Listen, if you don't want to do it because they ain't dropping money in the tip jar, I don't blame you. Listen, they don't run things over here. What you thought this was? What is going on in the chat?
All right, let me see. All right, I'm going to sing this. This is Khalid. Talk. I love this song.
Come on, talk to me.
Oh, yeah. Can we just talk? Can we just talk? Talk about where we're going before we get lost. Let me your thoughts get what we want without knowing. I never felt like this before. I apologize if I'm moving too far. Can we just talk? Can we just talk, figure out where we're going, yeah. Started off right, I can see it in your eyes. I can tell that you wanted more. What's been on your mind and the reason we should hide? Tell me something unheard before, baby. I've been dreaming about it and what you want. Stop thinking about it. Can we just talk, babe? Can we just talk? Talk about where we going before we
come
get
on, chat.
Thoughts. Let me your thoughts. Get when we want.
Y'all better light this chat up right now.
Never felt like this before. I apologize if I'm going too far. Can we just talk? Can we just talk? Figure out where we're going. Yeah, yeah.
Come on, Michelle. You gotta turn it up.
Hey.
Turn it up, Michelle. You go ahead and spit that right there. Hey, spit that.
Dream about it, and I'm what you want. Oh, so stop thinking about it. Can we just start? Talk about where we're going before we get lost. Let me on thought and get what we want without knowing. I've never felt like this before. I apologize if I'm going too far. Can we just talk? Can we just talk? Figure out where we're growing.
Yeah. Hey, you better hit those notes right there. Drop them bombs on it.
No, you gotta stop parts. Interrupting my music with those sounds. No, I'm just kidding.
You can't stop them from pressing the buttons.
I gotta drop the bombs on it, man. Listen, you can't give them everything over here. You gotta drop the bombs on it so they gotta be like, oh man, I missed that note. I gotta listen harder this time. I gotta listen harder so I can hear what she's doing. Hey, listen, that was dope though. I like that. I like that a lot. The only thing I'm upset about is I can't go on Spotify and look up Michelle Sussett. I said it right at that time, right? Sussett? Hey, I can't go on Spotify and look up Michelle Sussett. Like, what's going on with that? You need to come through with the album, a single.
Regáñame. I know. Soon come.
Listen, man. Yo, we finna go over the bridge. And when we get over the bridge, we're gonna have ourselves a cold coconut. Listen, dog, I'm about to go and follow you on Instagram really quick. Let me go and follow you on Instagram.
That's a good idea.
Let me go and follow you real quick, man. Shout out to everybody in the chat right now. If y'all don't got her on Instagram right now, you know, do it. Do the ting right here. We about to go find her on Instagram right now. If I can find her.
Man, I gotta get on social media.
You better get on social media. Yeah,
but I don't use it as much. I don't know why. I feel like I focus.
You better get on social media. Listen, I'm trying to tell you, I'm about to hit this follow button right here. And if you don't get on social media and follow me back, I'm taking back all my bombs that I dropped. Now, how about that right there? Listen, yo, y'all better go and follow her right here. There it is. There it is right there. Y'all go follow. I'm about to hit the blue. Yeah, there you go. Boom. I followed that joint right there. Greg just followed that joint right there. Y'all make sure y'all go and follow her on Instagram and harass her about an album.
That's message her every day. When's the album coming out?
Come on, man. Harass her. Harass her about this album. Harass her about the singles. Harass her about the label. Harass her about performing. Just do everything you're not supposed to do as a person. Listen. So when you get over the bridge. You're in Florida, right? You're in Miami.
Yeah.
When are you gonna do a show with Latitude 28 band, man?
What was that?
When are you gonna do a show with Latitude 28 band?
Our band.
Come down to Miami.
Actually. Wait a minute. We went to Key West, and I don't know if I'm looking forward to going back that route. I don't know, man.
No, we played at a small stage, and it was like a year ago.
I don't know. Just the traffic in Miami. Ain't nobody trying to deal with. Ain't nobody.
Oh,
got
we did
time
get stuck
that.
On the turnpike for like 4 hours. Palm Beach.
Didn't you say you were in West Palm Beach? Where are you?
We went to Key West.
Key West,
my bad.
We did Key West and we did Coral Gables, which is Miami pretty much.
We're in Central Florida, so we're like maybe 3 or 4 hours away from you.
No, well,
right?
We'll put you on our roster and somebody will message you and plan something.
Is there a casino? Right, let's go to a casino in Miami.
Don't talk to me about casinos.
You go to casinos?
Nah, not really. Only, yes. Only
stay away.
It's a flat line for. Hold on,
it's a no for me, dog.
It's a no, man. Go to casinos.
Don't do it.
No, honestly, I just like to play the roulette.
Yeah, what's up? Wait, yeah, hey, yo, which one? Which one are you? Are you red or black? Are you red or black?
Man, I. So this is how I play.
I'm putting you on the spot right now. Red or black?
I see. If the red is coming out too much, then I go black. But if the black comes out too much, then I go red. And that's how you do it.
But, yeah. But that's not what we're asking you right now. Are you red or black, ma'am? Red or black? You got to choose one.
Why?
You have to choose one. Nah, your life depends. Your life depends on this choice right here. If you got to go all in.
What if I like the best of both worlds?
But what if you got to go all in?
What if somebody gave you 10 grand and they were like, you have to bet either black or red?
You have to put it all in. What are you choosing?
I wouldn't do it for 10 grand.
No, but you can't have it unless you put it on there.
You got to put it on something. What are you putting it on?
For real? You're really making me choose. Okay, I'll go for black.
Black. All right. Black it is.
It's a no for me, dog.
We're Team Rojo.
Rojo, baby. Yo, Rojo, where you at in the chat? Let me see what a Team Rojo at. I put
all my money
on red
all the time, over and
team
over and over.
Team Rojo, where you at? You understand.
But it's Avi, our band manager.
But you know, if you're playing the digital roulette, you can't really play if you're alone, right? You got to play with like a bunch of players at the same time.
This is why you got to come to the casinos. Yeah, I understand.
We happened to accidentally get booked by casinos. I don't know. Maybe it was an accident. But all the time, casinos. Why is there a casino right there? Huh. And then there we are every night gambling.
No way.
It's terrible.
Yo, the time I went to Las Vegas, I was auditioning for The Voice. And I went with my cousin, right? And so after the audition, we went on the casino. I made $200, he made $2,000 out of $300 that he was playing.
What was he putting it on? What was he putting it on?
On roulette. We were playing roulette.
Now, which color was he putting it on? I know he was putting it on color.
I'm telling you, he was playing the best of both worlds, red and black.
Yeah, you got to alternate sometimes.
And green, of course.
Avi, sometimes.
Green, you put a little tab.
Following your gut.
Yeah. Avi said, Avi walks in. He said, why aren't you guys betting on red? And ever since we've been betting it on red and been winning them big 30 bucks.
Except when the guy came in with the black t-shirt and jinked us.
Nah, the guy with the juju vibes. Yo, we're going to drop a flat line for that guy right there. Yeah, the guy with the juju vibes.
We were playing one night and there was this guy that would come by and like stare at the table and he was just wearing this black shirt.
He wouldn't even say anything. We would ask him like, yo, red or black? He wouldn't even say it. He'd look at us. Like, bro, get away from our table with the juju vibes, bro. You got to be sure. You got to be a sure ting over there. You got to be either red or black. Bro, listen. Hey, I'm trying to put y'all on game. If y'all don't go to casinos, y'all better start doing it. Y'all better start doing it.
No, I don't recommend it.
No, let me tell you something. After what I saw that day, I couldn't keep on playing in the casinos. I saw my cousin winning $2,000 and losing him like this.
Yep.
Yeah.
Like, literally, we got the $2,000. We went out. We ate something, and then we got back in a different casino, and he lost it all, man. And he was so desperate. Like, I was next to him. I was literally about to slap him. I don't know why I didn't slap him. But anyway, he lost all the money, and when he lost it all, he was like, Michelle, give me $100. I promise you I'm going to make it right now. I promise you. And I did. I gave him $100, and he made it. But after that day, I was like, not anymore.
It costs to be the boss in those things.
It's dangerous.
Man.
Casinos are dangerous.
Man, listen, we could talk to Michelle all night.
Well, yeah,
we still got Demetrius up on deck. I know Demetrius over there like, man, but he's punching in the air right now. Like, when am I getting, you understand? Yeah, man. But shout out to you. We're going to be waiting on that single. We're going to be looking. We're going to be following. I'm going to be in your DMs like, where the album at every day. Hey, man, I got to do it.
As soon as the album does come out, we're going to play it.
I
got
to do it. Every day I'm going to be on your Instagram commenting, where's the album? Every picture. It don't have to do nothing with music. You could be like at a food place with your grandmoms or something. I'm be like, yo, the album though. You know what I'm saying? Like the album. Like, come on, yo. This is Michelle Sussett. Make sure y'all
you don't gotta
follow
like my face, but I'll take the motivational quote. Thank you. Can I say something? Since we started the show, you've been motivating me. I don't know. You got something related with motivation. He's maybe a motivator. You should be a motivational speaker too. So
no. Ain't none of that going on. This heavy metal trap, baby. We T Rojo. We music artists and things of the sorts like that, and we walk around and drink cold coconuts. This was Michelle Sussett, man. Make sure y'all go and follow that chick, man. Yes. Understand. Yo, Michelle, thank you for coming on the show. And giving
thank
us the time of the
guys.
Day. You know, that was dope. That was dope. You sung two songs. That was dope.
We win.
We could have went for a third, but we still got to bring in Demetrius before he punches a hole in the
I
air.
I got you.
So,
right now.
Yeah, we
do it right now.
Oh, no. See, now you're doing this. You're doing the tings. You know what? Since you're teasing it, you might as well.
All right, one more.
You might as well.
Dale.
Oh, what you about to do? You gonna play something we can dance to or what?
Can I play a cover? Would that be allowed right now?
I don't care. What? I don't care what you do. As long as you don't curse.
This that for weed chicken.
It's that for weed chicken, man.
Hey, I'm looking forward to seeing with you guys. If, you know, whenever this whole coronavirus is over.
Next week.
If I go to the Key West or you come down to Miami.
Next week.
Got a couple stages you can jump on. So
next week. Hey.
If you don't wanna see me somebody, did a full 180, crazy, thinking about the way I was, did the heartbreak change me, baby? But look at where I ended up. I'm all good already, so moved on and scary. I'm not where you left me at all. So, if you don't want to see me dancing with somebody, if you would not believe that anything could stop me, don't show up, don't come out. Don't stop caring, I found me now. Walk away, you know how. Don't stop caring, I found me now. Weren't you the guy who tried to hurt me with the word goodbye? Though it took some time to survive you. Look at where I ended up. I'm a good already, it's almost done and scary. I'm not where you left me at all. So, if you don't want to see me dancing with somebody, if you wanna believe in anything to stop me, don't show up, don't come out. Don't stop caring about me now. Walk away, you know how. Don't stop caring about me now.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Yes. Hey. Thank you so much. We'll be in touch. Talk to you later.
We'll holler at you.
Talk to you later.
We'll holler at you. Take it easier.